Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the FIFA Mini Series 2024. So we are back on the Racecourse Stadium today, 25th of March, and we are here to the second and the last day of the series today in the international friendlies. So last Friday we had our first two matches. First between the Central African Republic and Bhutan, where Central African Republic won by 6 goals, and unfortunately Bhutan couldn't gain any goals. And the second match in the evening was between Sri Lanka and Papua New Guinea. So there we had a very competitive time. We saw both of the team playing very well, where the ground was breaking its limits, where none of the teams could actually score a goal. But we saw a really good competition, a really good match, and we really enjoyed. We saw a grand crowd cheering up, chanting their names. So now, today we are here with the second and the last series. Starting off is Central African Republic and Papua New Guinea as the first matches. And then in the evening we have Sri Lanka and Bhutan. So welcoming you all for this match. Football is FIFA and we are here to the global celebration of football. Welcome everyone.
Welcome all of you for live action of day 2 in the FIFA series 2024 Sri Lankan edition. Day 2 action begins with the match between Central African Republic and Papua New Guinea. It's a nice warm day in Racecourse Stadium, Colombo today. Expecting a full house later in the day today. Central African Republic taking on Papua New Guinea in Racecourse Stadium, Colombo. Two higher ranked teams out of the four teams in FIFA Series 2024 Sri Lankan edition, as you see. Dressing room of Central African Republic. What an action-packed day. It was the day one, and we can expect action to be bigger and better today. The Central African Republic team had a landslide win over Bhutan, 6-0 on the first day, and they'll be looking to extend their winning run today as well.
Well, we don't care about the opponent. We are here to work together and to find the right way, especially for the World Cup qualifiers in June. So then we don't care about the opponent. We are going to work as a team. We show some good things in the first half, better in the second half. So now we are going to work as a team and see some players in the other positions maybe. We are changing the tactical system as well. So yeah, we'll see. It's another story, but as I said, you don't care about the opponent.
There you go, the coach speaking to us exclusively. The Papua New Guinean dressing room on pictures. It always gives you immense pride to represent your team at the highest level. Papua New Guinean team had a decent outing against Sri Lanka on 22nd. There you see the arrival of the Papua New Guinea team.
A very good side who showed their quality against Bhutan the other day, and so we expect a real tough challenge in these conditions. I mean, I much prefer the other night. I know you mentioned that the ground conditions, but I had no issue with the rain. It cooled it down a bit. It's really hot today, really oppressive conditions, so I think it's going to be a challenge for both teams, but I think for us it's all about improvement. We know we're up against a really good side, but we're looking for little key indicators that we can build our preparation for the Nations Cup in June.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the national anthem of Papua New Guinea.
Pictures, the Central African Republic team card, Geoffrey Didais, Yango Flory, Yunga Amos, Namanga Khal, Babola Gislaine, Pidia O'Brad, Chatolina Severin, Dangabo Hamisu, Godame Thierry, Christian Theodore, and Guinari Peter, head coach by Savoy Raoul. I welcome my co-commentator for the day, Kavinka.
Hello Akhil, and a very good afternoon to everyone listening in and joining us. Here we have Central African Republic lineup. As you mentioned, a really strong one for today. Just like what they did versus Bhutan, they'd want to replicate exactly that. Referees for Dilan Pereira from Sri Lanka,
Alita Hematunga
from Sri Lanka as well, and the two Sri Lankan assistants Sanjeeva Premalal and Kasun Veerakodi. Look at your Papua New Guinea lineup. Daniel Joe at right back, Kolu Kepo, Yaga Yasasa, Jesse Grese, Emmanuel Simon, Philip Stephen, Joseph YY, Troby Dobbin, Lina Vufont, Peter Dabinyaba Jr., and Ronald Warison. Head coach, Warren Moon. And here are your substitutes for this afternoon's game. Fairly hot conditions here, Akhil, as we gear up for the kickoff. Central African Republic all clad in blue, while Papua New Guinea in their away strip in yellow and black. Referee Akila waiting to give the signal for the 3 p.m. kickoff. We are underway here at the Racecourse International Stadium. Central African Republic kick us off. And they will be trying to score to the goal that is on the right of your screen while Papua New Guinea attempt to defend. Well, Central African Republic come into this game, Akhil, with 6 goals to the good against Bhutan. Papua New Guinea, a stalemate against Sri Lanka. I would say that it was well defended and the midfield did well to hold up the play. But it's their attack that is lacking. Of course Warren Moon would have done his weekend homework and is definitely looking to bolster that attack. It's a good ball played in here. Papua New Guinea with the first chance. And it's an attempted cross, really. I think Yasasa was attempting to cross that into his strike partner, Gressé, but the bench and everyone in here, as we look at the replay, he should have gone for the shot, really, Akhil. What are your thoughts on that?
Early opportunity for Papua New Guinea there. We can expect a good game today, Kavinka. We saw how good in defense was Papua New Guinea on the match against Sri Lanka. And we saw how good the Central African Republic on the attack.
So yeah, absolutely. Referee just sorting out a bit of formalities in the penalty box. Short corner taken. Is played, or rather it was a shot, and Dominique rather Lembe Jeffrey replacing Dominique was happy to see that one away.
Early signs of aggression from Papua New Guinea today.
There's Coach Savoy, Raul Savoy. He definitely has some experience here in the Central African Republic management. He's also got a quite fair bit of history with managing African sides and also African club sides. Much of his experience is actually in Africa. He coached Gambia and Swaziland and Algeria. He managed 2 clubs as a yellow card is issued and is quickly taken by Central African Republic. Here's a cross in and it's nicely claimed by the captain of Papua New Guinea, Ronald. Coming back to Coach Raul Savoy. It's not the first time he's coaching Central African Republic. As confirmation there, a yellow card is issued to Joseph YY of Papua New Guinea.
Throw in for Papua New Guinea.
Issued in here and it's comfortably claimed again by Ronald as he gets it quickly underway, and Danjo is on the wing looking to counter attack. He's quickly stopped in the tracks by Central African Republic midfield. Now, something that Papua New Guinea would not want to do, something what they did during the Sri Lanka match, was to give the ball away a few times in the midfield as well as the defense, Akhil, because we saw how quickly they can be punished by the opposition, or rather how quickly they can be punished by Central African Republic, because that's what Bhutan did. Second goal of what Central African Republic scored was actually a result of a mistake.
totally contrasting conditions for Papua New Guinea from the first day action. They are seems like they are enjoying the conditions today other than the first day action versus Sri Lanka.
Yeah, definitely. The pitch looks good compared to what they were accustomed to on Friday night, because we were looking at a very damp pitch. The ball was not traveling quite well. Sometimes it skidded off the pitch at certain times. But now it looks to be bright sunshine here as the ball is lofted into the wing. Thoughts of a cross by Daniel Joe. Daniel Joe at right back plays for Leh City FC. And he is actually the fifth all-time highest caps retainer of Papua New Guinea with 22 caps. Also with 22 caps is Emmanuel Simon. Emmanuel Simon also slotting into that midfield. Here's Dan Joe. It's a good crossing but fails to find anyone in yellow. Central African Republic get it underway. And that was a wonderful block by Kolu Kepo. Babula Gisley. Flory. Peter out to Severin. Here's Gisley. Rewarded with a start for his goal against Bhutan. Seems that Papua New Guinea started well here, Akil, because we saw how pitched in they were against Sri Lanka. Here's a lofted cross, and much to the disappointment of Carl, who bagged two goals, so he's no stranger to scoring.
Likes of Carl, Ghislaine, and also Flory were instrumental on the win against Bhutan on the other day. Central African Republic.
Neatly, as we take a look at the replay, Donald was caught in two minds, really, of whether to watch it sail over his head or catch it. But Papua New Guinea have it underway here. Throw by Font. There's Gresse getting the second corner for Papua New Guinea.
Two higher-ranked teams out of the four teams in FIFA Series 2024 Sri Lankan edition, Kavinka.
Yeah, definitely. And they are no stranger to success as well. Central African Republic, their first trophy was in 2009 when they won the Central African Economic and Monetary Community, beating Equatorial Guinea 3-0. It is a cross in and it's wonderfully dealt with by the Central African Republic defense. They also beat Algeria at home 2-0 in 2012 at the AFCON, the African Cup of Nations. You see another replay.
Good bit of defensive work there by Central African Republic.
There's another cross, but comfortably into the hands of Lembe. Lembe coming in for Dominique, as we said earlier. And it's a good lofted, and it's called offside by the assistant referee. Central African Republic actually beat Egypt in the AFCON qualifiers in 3-2. And would you believe it, that was Egypt's first home loss since 1965 when they beat them. And they played it against a 10-man Central African Republic as well. So miracles do happen, and Central African Republic are no stranger to them.
Sh- shows how good they can be on their particular day.
Absolutely. As of recent 2021 and the 2023 AFCON titles, they've not been able to secure anything. But here's a chance for Papua New Guinea. And unfortunately, into the hands of Lambe. The pass was just a bit too overcooked there. So there's been action in this opening 10 minutes, Akhil. How do you see this playing out in terms of tactics? Because both sides seem to have spotted some sort of gap in each of the other's defense. Central African Republic opting to play from the wings, whereas Papua New Guinea playing from the center. And here's Central African Republic again. Here's a shot coming in, and it's a goal for Central African Republic. It's Christian Theodore who comfortably guides it in. And we have a goal here in the opening 11 minutes at the FIFA Series 2024.
As you see on the picture, the beautiful lead by Babana Gislain. Perfectly finished there by Christian Theodore. Both the teams have been attacking from the very first minute, and Central African Republic coming jubilant.
It's almost like they heard us, because we did mention that Central African Republic likes to play from the wing. They also played from the wing in the Bhutan match as well. And this time another example was actually Babalu Gislain, who did quite well with his skill there. Got past the defense like they were traffic cones, and really easy pickings for Christian Theodore.
Gislain rightfully starting for Central African Republic today.
Oh, and here's another mistake by Papua New Guinea. Christian Theodore, his first start here at the Sri Lanka edition of the FIFA Series 2024. So Papua New Guinea have some comeback to do. They'll try to get it in the form of their attack. Here they are. It's Gressé on the ball against Amos. Amos doing really well to stay with his striker there, but it was a foul really calling, but the ref says play on. There was a shot. Yagi Asasa getting the shot away.
We are in for some thrilling, entertaining 90 minutes of action today, Kavinka.
Yeah, of course, and entertainment and action are no strangers, like we said, to Central African Republic. Actually, 21 of their 23 players play abroad, with 9 players playing in France. So, the French, the Ligue 1. We have 3 players playing in the Ligue 1. Not regular starters, but since that experience accounts for something, I can say they're well equipped. Here's another chance for Central African Republic, and another shot goes away. Cleared out by Papua New Guinea. Dangerous times here in the last 5 minutes, with a goal coming and about 2 chances.
We saw in the previous game as well, Central African Republic took a bit of time to get into the rhythm. Once they get into the rhythm, they were unstoppable.
Central African Republic's highest ranking was 49th in October 2017, so they do have experience getting into. And here is Central African Republic, but the shot goes over and it almost actually reaches the rugby post, so would have hoped for maybe a three-pointer, but unfortunately this is the wrong game. Would have been easy pickings for Carl if Danjo didn't get his head to the ball to deflect it away from Carl. Here's Danjo again. Doing well against his man and drawing in a foul. That's good play from Danjo.
Good weather today in race course. Let's hope it will stay out the same way today.
You could play a good weather for us in the commentary box. Not sure what the players are feeling out there because it feels like about 34 degrees. Here's Flory, here's Ghislaine. Ghislaine out to Thierry. Here's Flory again.
Let's get into more history on Central African Republic. Sri Lanka. And their football.
Absolutely. And so Central African Republic, like we said, 49th was their highest ranking in 2007-2012. But one win in the last five games, a bit concerning for Coach Rahul and his side. We did compliment Papua New Guinea's midfield in the previous game, but this time around, seems like it's a bit too much for them as the goal scorer, Christian Theodore, is out-muscled.
Breaking into the top 50 in world rankings is a tremendous achievement, Kavinka. With Central, that should be the best achievement in the history of football for Central African Republic.
Exactly, when you get wins against Algeria in 2012 and also Egypt, you are bound for at least a bit of greatness because those two are premier sides in the AFCON and also mostly revered in Africa. Both sides have made World Cup finals appearances as well. Ghislaine, who has been in the thick of things. Ghislaine charging at four people. Flory. Peter to Amos, his captain. Here's Severin, who was bombing up and down the left wing for Central African Republic. Blues are keeping the ball well here. Severin trying to look for the run of Carl, but Carl is offside on that instance. Ghislaine was screaming for the run. Here is Hamizu. Hamizu floats one in. The ball rolls out for a corner kick. Well, an early substitution here for Papua New Guinea. Karo Killa, if your pardon, comes on for Philip Stephen. So, a defender for a defender. Not sure what exactly the reason is, but Karo Karila comes on into the thick of action and finds himself defending a corner. Karo Killa came on as a substitute in the previous match as well against Sri Lanka.
Corner for Central African Republic.
Severin floats it in. Well dealt with by Ronald. Severin again. Carl. Pardon, that was Christian Theodore. All the way to Lambert. And out it goes for a throw-in.
Papua New Guinea on the attack. Goal kick for Central African Republic. Central African Republic have had fair amount of possession so far in this game. They have resulted in a positive manner with an early goal. Hugo Amos playing on the back, the captain.
Severin looking for options in the box. Nice interplay there. Yes, Amizu goes down asking questions from the ref, but the ref says play on. Here's Severin looking for options once again. But out by the Papua New Guinea defense. Actually, more than about five players are there. And here's another shot. But skewed out wide.
Shot attempted there by the goal scorer, Christian Theodore. I beg your pardon, Christian Theodore. Shot taken there. Ronald Wilson did a decent job in the match against Sri Lanka.
Yeah, and definitely has his work to do here. Central African Republic, not a side you can rest against as well, Akhil. Because it seems like every bit of play, they're coming at your goal. But for now, it's Papua New Guinea with ball stolen by Mizu on that side. Here's Carl Flores. Beg your pardon, Flory. Carl asking for the ball. Bit of a trick attempted there, but Central African Republic go again. Severin. Played out to Ghislain. Ghislain tricks his way. And it's a goal for Central African Republic. They double their lead. Let's go down the theory.
Goddamn Thierry and his strike partner Babula Gislin. It's a cheeky chip there by Thierry. And Central African Republic, two goals to the good here at the Racecourse International Stadium.
Once again, a beautiful pass there by Babula Gislin, just as similar to the first goal there. Beautifully finished there by Godame Thierry. A literal chip there by Thierry, the number 17 of Central African Republic. So we are in 25 minutes of the game. Central African Republic already with two goals.
Coach Warren Moon at his press conference last week said that their side will be hoping for a challenge and it won't be easy, but Central African Republic in this tournament so far, well, they're not making it any easy for their opponents. Here's Danjo looking for a cross, bounces off Severin. Here's Christian Theodore. Gislin finding himself on the right wing now. So it seems that most players have been given that leeway to act as a free player, something that we don't see quite often when it comes to professional matches. But in the previous match, sorry, Akhil, but in the previous match.
See the referee, Krishanta Dilan Pereira from Sri Lanka, is one of the senior referees in the country, or have refereed a lot of important games. Good to see such referees getting an opportunity as well.
You're just coming back to that point about the free role and how they're playing. We saw it in the previous match with Tresor. He was a midfielder, but he was acting as a winger and striker. So it seems that Gislin and Hamizu are operating in that role in this game. And it seems to be working really well for Coach Raoul Savoy.
Correct, Kainka, the game against Bhutan also. They did the same way, which gave them a superb result. As you see on the pictures, the two goals by Central African Republic. Beautifully finished there by Christian. And the second goal on the pictures, Thierry. Just chipping it there, a beautiful pass by Babula Gislin.
Yeah, the Papua New Guinea defense seemed to have fallen asleep there because they didn't realize that Thierry was there. Not what you want to do against quick, versatile players, especially in the penalty area. Pretty sure that's what Coach Warren Moon is expecting his players to do.
You don't want to face a coach after conceding two goals within 25 minutes, Kavinka.
Definitely brings back a bit of nightmares during what we faced during our school days playing for school and also club level as well.
So the four teams will be in action today. Central African Republic, Papua New Guinea. And at 8:45 p.m. in the night, host Sri Lanka taking on Bhutan.
As you see, on have come forward to watch this afternoon game. They will be coming to watch this game, Sri Lanka versus Bhutan, at the Racecourse Stadium in Colombo today, or rather tonight, at 8:45 p.m. local time. So if you're watching and if you're in and around Colombo, I'm pretty sure you can make it, even though if you're in the other parts of Sri Lanka, you can make it for this match. But the players have received their instructions, they've downed their drinks, and it's time to go for, I should say, the second half of the first half. As you'd imagine, Coach Rahul looking relaxed there because he knows his players, the 51-year-old Swiss coach. As we said, not the first time he's coaching them. Previously coached in 2014, 2017 to 2019, and from 2021 onwards. Central African Republic trying to make it 3 in 30 minutes. Would be a bit harsh on Papua New Guinea, but Papua New Guinea's mistakes have allowed them to double their lead. So it'll be interesting to see how they can claw themselves back. Here's a good ball out to Ghislaine. Ghislaine putting his head up and it bounces off the substitute.
Kamika, what do you think about players not designated for any particular position but playing freely like what Central African players are doing? Is it what some other teams also should adapt?
Well, it's usually classified as the number 10 role in the international game. The number 10 is supposed to be that creative outlet and is given that free roaming opportunity in the final third of the pitch. The problem is the number 10 role has disappeared over time because most teams want much more output from their players, as we see an overcooked pass, but Ghislaine gets it in. Here's the first goal scorer, Theodore launches it and it's into the hands of Ronald. But coming back to your point, so we're seeing a bit of a dying breed of players. When you talk about the number 10, we see a lot of number 10s, notably players like Coutinho, James Rodriguez. Even Leo Messi was a number 10 for some time as well, or rather, he is the number 10 when you're talking about creative outlets. So it's a role that is freely there for the taking because of its free nature, but with more coaches wanting the players to do well, and here's an opportunity. He bounces off the bar. It was another opportunity for Ghislaine. Like we said, now finding himself on the left wing. Ghislaine with another chance. And it's out by the substitute, Keela. But there's an example of that free role being afforded to players who have their creativity, who can get past players, just like how we saw Ghislaine get past the Papua New Guinea defense there. Dan Joe trying to watch the ball go away, but the threat's not over. Severi on the ball. Short corner for Carl. Carl floats it in, but much to the disappointment of those in blue.
Ghislaine making things happening today for Central African Republic, creating a very close chance that they could have made it 3.
Yeah, the forward line seems to be enjoying themselves here. Maybe more chances than they would have hoped for against this defense. Nonetheless, they're doing well. But the scoreline doesn't speak for itself, actually. The first 5 minutes were all to do with Papua New Guinea and how they got two corners in the first half of the first 15 minutes.
Just like I mentioned a few minutes ago, Kavinka.
Here's a lovely ball chipped in, but Ronald seems to have read it really well. So there you have another opportunity for Godam Thierry, who seemed to have swapped positions with Carl. Carl, who was playing in the centre-forward position in the previous game, but this time around has opted to play in that number 10 role, just like his jersey says. So,
just like I mentioned earlier, having the forwards of Central African Republic, once they get into a rhythm, they seem to be unstoppable.
Maybe some inspiration would have been taken from the heroics of Jude Bellingham at Real Madrid. We see him playing as a midfield, but at the same time, he's playing in a striker position as well. So he's playing that second striker role, that number 10 role, the number 6 role sometimes as well. So you need someone versatile for that as well. You need someone who has that stealth and also that player that is fit, because such a role relies on match fitness, and the availability of a player is paramount to something like that. Akhil, sorry.
With the evolvement of the game, Kavinka, the fitness plays a major role. You have to be, your fitness have to be on par for all 90 minutes, Kavinka.
Yeah, especially in these conditions. Much of the ball has been sprayed out to Dan Joe on the wings there. Danjo is operating as sort of like a right wing, right back outlet. And as you mentioned, a lot relies on the fitness of players. No player is in the position that they were maybe about 20 years ago. The right back was just a right back, but right now, the right back and left back, or rather the full backs, are allowed more options to go forward. Most of them are very good at crosses as well. Defense sometimes plays a minimal role in those sorts of instances. We see right backs like Trent Alexander-Arnold at Liverpool and also Reece James. Players like that, they have a special gift to go forward and make chances happen. So that's, I think, what Coach Warren Moon is trying to see out with Dan Joe on that right-hand side, because most of their passes have come through that side. Is Carl on the ball? Theodore. Out to Flory. Flory looking up, finds Ghislaine. Ghislaine, Theodore. Theodore doing well to hold against his man. This is Brad. I'm thinking of a shot, Severin, but it goes way over the bar.
As she is Severin taking the kick there, the ball goes way out of the bar. You have seen the same mistake committed by Papua New Guinea, which they did against Sri Lanka, giving away the ball cheaply, I would say, Kavinka.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's going to places that they don't want the ball to go to as well. The passes have not been directly to players at times. Coach Warren Moon has been out of his technical area for some time now, and rightly so, because his players are cheaply giving the ball away. Not what he would have hoped for. Here's a good pass played out to Ghislaine. Ghislaine twisting, turning, does well to turn against his defender. There's a chance, cries for penalty. unfortunately, Papua New Guinea can't get it out of their own half yet again. Is Peter out to Brad? Here's Gislin. Raul Savoy also would be asking the question, why are we missing all these chances and why are all these crosses going against us? Because we're seeing so many balls put into the box, Akhil, but it seems like most of them are finding the hands of Ronald. There's a big collision there. That was Gislin and...
You call it a high tackle?
Kilo. No, I wouldn't say that was a high tackle. I think that was just a bad coming together. I think we would have heard the shin pads coming together. Here's a Lakmal Veerakodi for the Fisher.
Central African Republic with possession right now. Whenever Papua New Guinea had some possession, they have given it away. Where Central African Republic have taken it gracefully.
And a bit of a cage game going on here. Not exactly what Papua New Guinea hoped for when you talk about getting it out of that cage, but here comes Central African Republic again. But Papua New Guinea are no... They're not a stranger to this sort of play. They were pitted against in the match against Sri Lanka. He's thinking about a shot. Hamizu. Once again... goes over the bar. But Papua New Guinea too have enjoyed their fair bit of success. Highest ranking 153rd, going way back to 2017 June. They also reached the Oceania Football Confederation Finals in 2012, but lost to New Zealand on penalties. Although they have their record at 10-0 versus Malaysia being their biggest loss as recent as 2023. They also have a massive win dating back to 1987 when they beat American Samoa 20-0. So they've been on
both sides.
Ends. Exactly. 10-0 loss and a 20-0 win. And unlike the Central African Republic side, most of the players play in Papua New Guinea, actually. But the results are worrying for them. 4 competitive games and 0 wins. Coming back to that stat about most of their players playing in Papua New Guinea, 11 of them actually play in Hikari United in Papua New Guinea.
As we are approaching the end of the first half, Central African Republic with a lead of 2-0. We have some guests coming all the way from Central African Republic to watch the match today. They'll be delighted as they won the first game by 6-0 and already leading the second game. by 2-0 in the first half.
Here's a chance for Papua New Guinea. And a poor cross in there.
Additional time.
Confirmation of 3 added minutes on the clock. Here's Central African Republic going once again. And there is the easiest of goals. And once again is Godam Thierry. Tripling the digits. It was a swift counter-attack. And the easiest of tap-ins, courtesy of another goal scorer, Christian Theodore. So, 2 goal scorers combining for another goal, Christian Theodore and Godam Thierry.
Easy as you come for Thierry there. Kavinka, what a goal. Thierry just chipping it in, just as he did in the second goal. Are we in for another flourish of goals from Central African Republic, just as the first day?
Or maybe more, for that matter, because just to remind you and all the viewers at home and around the world that Bhutan was actually 1-0 down, but Papua New Guinea are finding themselves 3-0.
We are currently at the extra time of 3 minutes in the first half.
Is Danjo with an opportunity to get a goal? There's a foul there. Bit away from the box, but it's a good chance for Papua New Guinea to get something back here and reduce the deficit to 2-0. Beg your pardon, 2 goals. Well, in the previous game, Central African Republic really out-muscled and outsized that Bhutan defense and the attack. But this time around, maybe they're looking a bit different. Is Emmanuel Simon on the ball? Discussing where he should put this. Four in the wall for Central African Republic. And he doesn't go their way once again. And here's another chance for Carl to come over and cause more havoc for Papua New Guinea. Quickly gets it back. Danjo puts the cross in. Cressy trying to be on the end of that. But it's Severin who gets it out. And it's halftime. Easy as 1-2-3. That's the scoreline here at the Racecourse International Stadium. Central African Republic. Easy goings for them against Papua New Guinea. It's 3-0. In the first half of this match, the first match of match day 2 of the FIFA Series 2024, the Sri Lanka edition, and it's Central African Republic 3, Papua New Guinea 0.
As you see the highlights of the first half action of the day two, the first game. Central African Republic taking on Papua New Guinea. That's the first goal for Central African Republic there. They created chances one after the other. Gislaine with the assist and Tiedi finishing the second goal there. As he got another close opportunity. And that's the third opportunity after opportunity created by Central African Republic there. That's the third goal. Easy as you come for Godame Thierry scoring his second goal of the game. Central African Republic leading at halftime, 3-0. Christian Theodore with one goal and Godame Thierry with twin goals. We will catch you with the live action from the second half from Sri Lanka Football TV and SBC TV. We will have an interview coming up. So that marks the end of the first half. I will catch you with the live action from second half.
Good afternoon, everyone. We are back live presenting from the race course stadiums from SBC TV. So here we are after the first half of the first match between Central African Republic and Papua New Guinea. And same like the first day, African Republic has scored 3 points and Papua New Guinea couldn't actually score any points today in the first half, but we'll be waiting for the second half as well. So we'll give an update after the second half, and now we have a small break, and then in the evening we'll start with the next match.
1 2 mic check 1 2 3 4 check 1 testing 1 2 mic check 1 2 3 4 check 1 check 1 2 mic check 1 2 3 4 testing 1 2 mic check 1 2 3
See some of the highlights here of the first session, the first half of the Central African Republic versus Papua New Guinea. Chance for Ghislaine doing well, and Ronald was actually called into action many times during that first half. You see opportunity wave after wave. And it was only for the two goal scorers, Christian Theodore and Godam Thierry, to triple the lead.
That's a half-time score. Central African Republic with 3 goals and Papua New Guinea with none against them so far. And here's my own turn to climb, Kiwanka.
Yeah, it looks like Coach Warren Moon has taken things into account and is preparing 3 substitutions. As we see, Amos leading out his men. So there we have some substitutions for both sides, actually triple substitution for both sides. Just to confirm, Jesse Grisse coming off and Joseph Waiwai coming off as well. Joseph Waiwai with a yellow card as we get things underway. Ati Kepo and Obert Pika coming on as substitutes. And for Central African Republic, Kaimba Stefan, Sole Isaac, and Wesley coming on for Central African Republic.
Fresh legs added for both the teams. Recently added Wesley is one of the goal scorers for Central African Republic on the game against Bhutan.
So in total, Papua New Guinea have made 4 substitutions. Karo Keela also made way in the first half.
A huge mountain to climb for Papua New Guinea. Easy as you go, under pressure. Central African Republic goalkeeper dealing it with much ease in the end.
Just that one more confirmation for Papua New Guinea defender Godfrey Haro coming on as well, in addition to Ati Kepo and Sylvester Wafunhuya.
See on the screen the substitutions for Central African Republic just after half time.
Central African Republic with a short corner. Cross coming in. And the shot.
I'm not sure what he did try there.
He was looking, definitely, he was looking for the top corner, go down Thierry. Trying to make it. 3 goes to his name.
Central African
chance for Central African Republic. There's a shot saved by Ronald. And once again, just like we saw in the first half, Akhil, we're seeing another onslaught. Here they come again. Cross is floated in. Once again dealt with. But the danger's not over. Seems like they're having a futsal session inside the penalty area there. Central African Republic. Just away from your screen, we see Coach Warren frantic at his players. Sure what he's seeing, but he's definitely seeing the talent of Central African Republic as another cross is coming in. On the way again, and here's Central African Republic finally on the back foot for a while, but only for a few seconds.
Ronald Wilson being tested early in the second half there by Central African Republic.
Here's Gislin. His substitute, Kaimba. Kaimba Stefan into the box. Here he finds another substitute, Wesley. But he's dispossessed. Once again, and Gislin. Beg your pardon, that was Hamizu. Ramos. Kaimba Stefan. Here's Gislin. Hamizu wrestling for the ball with new substitute Wafunhuya. And eventually gets the free kick. We see another replay of that attempt. It was a good save. Luckily for Papua New Guinea, the ball didn't fall into the hands of the feet of a blue shirt. Good work there by Ronald. Here is another attempt, and it goes over the bar and over Ronald as well. He was clutching for something there, and it was Kaimba Stefan.
Very, very close there. Shot attempted by Isaac. Early intent shown by Central African Republic. Papua New Guinea will have to come up with a fight now.
Go down, Thierry. Two goals to his name. And we'll be looking for another goal. Well, it's no secret that Central African Republic have been the much more technically lovely side to watch. But that doesn't mean that Central African Republic can't be troubled by Papua New Guinea. Papua New Guinea, or rather, the couples, as they're called. They will be looking to claw their way back in, but maybe right after this chance. Here is Thierry. Nice interplay with Sole Isaac. And the ball goes out for a throw-in, courtesy of Sylvester. Here is Kaimba Stefan. Sole Isaac. Oh, and that's not a very good touch, and the referee is asked questions. But the referee doesn't give a penalty or a foul for any of that instance.
As you see on the replay, number 17 off.
Oh, and that may be a good cause for a penalty there, because Sylvester did not get the ball. The referee was behind. And that's a good chance for a penalty. Assuming we had VAR in Sri Lanka, of course that would have been looked at multiple amount of times, but this instance, Papua New Guinea get away with one.
The twin scorer, Gudami Thierry, being treated for an injury there.
Yep, but he's back on his feet, much to the joy of Coach Raul, as you see on screen. Bit relaxed today, and rightfully so. Don't see any reason why he should be worrying about his side, except for maybe a few injuries. But Gudam Thierry is back on his feet.
Yellow card from Central African Republic, player number 21, Gunari Peter.
Gunari Peter, confirmation of a yellow card. And that was a push there by... It was the new substitute, Ati Kepo. Almost going down there, asking why that wasn't called a foul, but... Here's Ghislaine. Ghislaine trying to find his compatriot, Hamizu. Danjo. Ati Kepo.
Bit of physical interaction going on between both the teams now.
Yeah, absolutely. Something that you'd want to watch. There is a confirmation of Gunari Peter. Well, that is also the thing. You tend to get frustrated when things aren't going your way. You tend to do things which are out of your control and manage things on your own, but that is surely not the way to go. I'm pretty sure that Coach Warren Moon would have instructed his players not to lose their cool on the pitch, even though you have sweltering conditions out there.
Also, Papua New Guinea have a mountain to climb. They are trailing by 3-0. They will have to show some intent and attack in order to stay in fight.
Yep, but here is Hamizu. Hamizu looking for Ghislaine. Hamizu once again, nice interplay. Here's Hamizu. There's Soleil Isaac wrestling for the ball with Danjo, but the Papua New Guinean gets it his way.
Corner for Papua New Guinea.
It's a task for one of the bigger men of the Papua New Guinea side to get their head to this ball. Yagi Asaso over the ball. Short corner is taken. Emmanuel Simon. Emmanuel Simon looking to float one in, and it's another corner. It seems not really. There is a chance for Thierry to do something, but it rolls into the path of Ronald, and Papua New Guinea go again. The bench of the Papua New Guinea side. Reminder that 6 substitutes can be used. Papua New Guinea have used 4 of them. Is Ghislaine bursting through? Ghislaine on the ball for Central African Republic. He was too quick there for both player and myself, mixing up the names of the sides as well. But wonderful play there by Ghislaine. He's been a standout there. Well, if the match were to end in the next 2 minutes, would he be your man of the match?
Of course, what a play by Ghislaine there. Unfortunately, with not enough support there to finish it.
A strong contender for man of the match. Not been on the score sheet, but definitely is up there to wow the eyes of the spectators over here.
This game can be very cruel at times. You do all the hard works and give you the assist, but your name doesn't come on the score sheet.
That's why it's very important not to look at only the names on the score sheet, also look at the stats and the facts. I'm pretty sure that all the players and coaches around the world would be accustomed to this. There are several sort of stats like XG, like expected goals, expected assists, expected goals conceded. So the statistical models used all around in world football. And you could see that something like what Hamizu is doing, even though he isn't on the score sheet, players like him are the reason why managers and also scouts look for statistics of other natures. Something that we've seen in the second half is the featuring of Ati Kepo trying to link his play with his compatriots but failing to do so. It's just that one extra pass and they've had their fair chances, and here is Thierry, but Ronald rushes out to get the ball. Unfortunately, it was called for offside. It's Kalu Kepo all the way to the other wing. Asking for the ball is Yasasa. Oh, and there's a lack of concentration there. Coach Warren Moon frantic about what he's just seen. It's not gone his way in this tournament, really. Papua New Guinea did have a few chances to win the match against Sri Lanka, but much to his disappointment, there wasn't a chance to be. It's Kaimba Stefan. Is Gislin. Hamizu. Sole Isaac. Kaimba Stefan. It's Kaimba Stefan. Floats one in and it just goes over the bar. A bit worrying there for Ronald, the captain of Papua New Guinea. Down at the touchline here, Central African Republic preparing a bit more substitutions as well.
Stefan with an attempt there. Tried to curve in, but still goes on top. And
yeah, Hamizu, the 21-year-old forward, scored in the last game as well. Plays for Nantes in France, so like I mentioned, a bit of Ligue 1 experience involved as well. Although not a regular starter, is experience that is invaluable. And there was a lovely ball there played by Stefan. Here's Sole Isaac. Comes back to Stefan. Stefan trying to think of a cross. Finds Hamizu instead. Hamizu, nice interplay with Gislin. But the assistant on the far side has called for offside. Substitutions coming up for Central African Republic.
Substitution for Central African Republic. Player number 7, Obunika.
And that's Gislin's afternoon coming to an end. What a player, what a performance that has been. Coming on for him is another showman, Choropite Tresso. And Christian Theodore coming off as well. Another goal scorer. Coming on for Marco Ludwin.
We saw the same tactic being adopted by Central African Republic in the first game as well.
And they seem to be adopting a 4-1-4-1. Trissor has gone into that midfield position like he did in the previous game. There's a nice interplay there by central by Papua New Guinea, gets it in. It's Troy Dobin. Stressor. Played out to Wesley.
What a tournament he has had, Kavinka. Babula Gislain. Easily the playmaker and for Central African Republic.
He played on both sides, fantastic in his output, and that's exactly what someone like Coach Raul Savoy wants to see. Just a confirmation on subs to Christian Theodore and Babula Gislain coming off for Marco Ludivon and Turapite Trissol.
One goal scorer goes and another goal scorer comes in for Central African Republic.
Definitely. Just show us how much of quality they have on the bench as well. Raul Savoy opting to rest Tresor. And here's a chance for Central African Republic once again. And there's a chance for the new substitute. That was Majuga Marco Ludivon. Rising high to get his head to the ball. It's fouled there on Ate Kepo. There's a replay of that chance by Marco Ludivon. Not a bad effort, really. Just needed a bit of power. There's a chance for Papua New Guinea, but comfortably into the hands of Lambert. Here's Amos. Down to Wesley on the right hand side. Tresor. Flory. Gunai Peter. Out to his fullback. And that's a cheap offside, really. And here's a chance for Papua New Guinea. Shouts off a penalty. Ref says that it was nothing but just a shoulder charge. Ate Kepo really has been in the thick of things, Akil.
Of course, Papua New Guinea with an opportunity there. With this 20 minutes of the game remaining as per o'clock, it will be interesting what Papua New Guinea will have to offer in the next 20 minutes. Well,
there's a foul there by Papua New Guinea. Foul on Wesley. Is that penalty shout once again? Yeah, the reason why Amos is laughing is probably because of the fact that he just used nothing but physical strength there, nothing to nothing artificial there to wipe out the threat of Ati Kepo. Is your weather conditions 30 degrees? It feels like we're in an oven, really.
Has been the story for last 2-3 months in Colombo. Other than one or two days with heavy showers.
There's a chance for Central African Republic.
Coach Savoy Raoul will be a very happy man. 9 goals in 2 games so far with 20 minutes remaining.
Yeah, he's seen his side come up as well. As we mentioned, he's coached them previously. He knows some of these lads as well. They know what they are capable of as well. So I'm pretty sure he and his coaching staff will be delighted to see a performance. Probably a few more goals and less wasted chances, but nothing concerning for the Swiss coach. Here's Amos. Gets it out to Sole Isaac. Marco Ludivo made a good run. Sole Isaac out to Wesley. Flory. Flory to Peter. Cause for a foul against the likes of Stefan. So they've scored a total of 9 goals in Sri Lanka. That's Yuga Amos,
the captain.
Central African Republic captain. When you have players like Jeffrey Kondogbia, who plays for Marseille and who has played for Atletico Madrid and the likes of Inter Milan as well, you need another leader to step up, and that's exactly what captain Yuga Amos has done. He'll be delighted to see this through with 2 clean sheets to his name as the players call in for drinks at this second matchup of the FIFA Series 2024. My name is Kavinka Fernando, and Akil Masloon as well. Akil, what do you feel about the match so far? Do you think that PNG could have maybe converted a few chances?
There were a few opportunities for PNG, although, but Central African Republic is mostly dominated through their forwards with the likes of Ghislaine attacking throughout the game. PNG should have come back with some attacking intent, but it has been mostly Central African Republic.
Here's a replay of the goals. Here's Ghislaine to Christian Theodore.
And the second goal. Assist by Ghislaine once again. Finished by Godame Thierry. Finished or chipped in by Godame Thierry there. Once again, easy as you go by Godame Thierry to mark the third goal for Central African Republic. What would be Warren Moon's advice for the boys from PNG with 14 minutes to go as per clock? Go all out?
First of all, the goal would be not to concede goals. because there would be no point in chasing goals if you are the one chasing. So that would be the first bit of advice he would be giving to his defense and also his team. But it doesn't look like they can do much, Akhil, because they've been out-muscled, out-maneuvered, and tactically we feel that coach Warren Moon might accept the fact that his players have been outperformed by them. But nothing doing. This is a friendly match. You're supposed to experiment and try out a bit of tactics that may work in your favor. What works in your favor, you can continue it into your competitive matches. But if it doesn't, then it's very right to sway away from those.
And finding out your best combination going forward, some crucial games coming up for your teams, it's important to find your correct combination.
Is Peter Amos. Stefan tries to float it in. Here's Thierry, and there's another goal. It's Godam Thierry with a hat trick. That's right, that's a number, Godam Thierry. It's been a brilliant day for him. Three goals to the good. And Central African Republic in cruise control.
Goal.
Was really a
Central
good
Republic
outward. Yeah, he did use his outward foot there.
What a day it has been for Godam Thierry, scoring his hat-trick. Beautiful finish there by Godam Thierry, increasing the goal tally for 4-0 for Central African Republic.
It was nicely done by Toro Pitic as well. And here comes off the goal scorer and the hat-trick getter. Go down Thierry. Work is done. He'll be replaced by Kulu Juste. Juste did start the previous match versus Bhutan. Was in the thick of things, but now he's being called on as a substitute. 10 minutes to play on the clock. Papua New Guinea may feel like as if this was theirs for the taking in the first 10 minutes of the game. But unfortunately, Central African Republic took note of that and clawed themselves back into it. Here's Ati Kepo playing like he has nothing to lose, but unfortunately loses on that challenge and draws in a foul. Confirmation of Kulu Juste coming in for the hat-trick getter, Godam Thierry.
We're entering the last 10 minutes of the game as per o'clock. Central African Republic with a dominating performance once again. Four goals to none against Papua New Guinea. 3 goals to Godam Thierry and 1 goal to Christian Tedo.
Yeah, it really shows the difference in quality between African sides and the Oceania sides as well. Here is Marco Ludivant, Toro Peter Tresor. Here's Toro Peter Tresor again, out to his captain, Amos. Sole Isaac. Peter to Amos. Sylvester. Sylvester puts in a cross. And that's the second time he's done it, really. It looked like a shot, but it was also disguised as a cross, so could have gone either way. There's Danjo.
Will there be a chance for a consolation for Papua New Guinea?
Substitution for Papua New Guinea. Player number 17, Kenneth Ara, replacing player number 4, Sylvester Wafunia.
So Sylvester Wafunia's time on the pitch has been drawn to a close. He was a substitute, so the substitute has been substituted. And here is Kenneth Ara coming in. So it's a defender for a midfielder. Warren Moon looking to shake things up here in the final 7 minutes of the Papua New Guinea's last match of the FIFA Series 2024 Sri Lanka edition. Marco Ludivant, Sylvester, Amos. Tresor. Marco Ludivant. Ludivant gets it back, and that is surely a foul there. Good call by the ref. Calls for a free kick. Marco Ludivant on the ground, feeling the effects of the challenge. There's a replay of that. Coming together with Arti Kepo.
Arti Kepo is everywhere.
Yeah, definitely has been a standout player in this second half for Papua New Guinea. Sole Isaac, could he make it number 5? It would be very harsh on Papua New Guinea if he does so. Here's a chance, and it was worrying Ronald for a bit. He had to dive just to make sure that it didn't creep into his net. It's a good shot by Sole Isaac.
Beautifully taken there by Isaac. See on the screen, Isaac taking a shot there. Ronald with a valiant attempt.
Sylvester doing well to get away from his man.
Beautifully taken there by Central African Republic.
It's Hamizu. Fortunately, not being on the same wavelength with Marco Ludivant.
Wesley in action.
Wesley floats it in. And here's a chance for Marco Lurimon to finish the game with another goal, but safely into the hands, or rather into the sensitive areas of Marco, or rather Ronald. Bit unfortunate there. He is requiring some treatment. Let's just hope that he can see out the rest of this game, because even though four goals have gone into his net, he has been a lively figure in that goal. Seems to be a trouble of a cramp there as well.
You see the last goal attempt there by Central African Republic, causing the injury for the captain of Papua New Guinea. Good to see him back.
Nicely taken there by Soleil Isaac. Feeds it out to Tresor. Tresor sprays it out wide to Sylvester. Sylvester trying to get another shot in, but once again, it goes way over the bar, and that's actually a hat-trick of attempts by Sylvester, trying to look for a cross, but failing to do so. Papua New Guinea getting ready for one more substitution. Oh, and there's a bit of a mistake there, coming together with Ati Kepo. Lambe has not had much to do, but here's a yellow card issued for, I believe it's Ati Kepo.
Nasty injury there for the goalkeeper of Central African Republic.
Rather, it's actually for Amos, the yellow card.
Correction in the yellow card update. Yellow card for Papua New Guinea, player number 6, Ati Kepo.
Well, correction again. Our sources confirmed to us that it is actually a yellow card and caution to Ati Kepo, as 3 minutes will be added on to end this troublesome time for Papua New Guinea.
3 minutes extra time added. As you see on the pictures, Ati Kepo with the yellow card.
Player number 16, Rex Nee. Replacing player number 11, Yagi Asasa.
And that's Yagi Asasa's evening coming to an end at the Racecourse International Stadium in Sri Lanka. Rex Naim coming on. Rex Naim actually was a substitute in the match against Sri Lanka and is coming on as a substitute for the final 3 minutes. Well, as for what's next, Central African Republic, their next game will be a World Cup 2026 qualification match versus Chad The date for that is to be announced. And for Papua New Guinea, the African, sorry, the Oceania Federation Confederations, rather should I say the Oceania Football Confederations Cup versus Fiji will be on the 16th of June 2024. Challenging conditions in Sri Lanka have probably given a blueprint for both coaches Rahul and Warren Moon to experiment with their sides, and definitely feels like both sides could do much better. If it stays like this, Central African Republic are ending their campaign in Sri Lanka with 10 goals and none conceded. So that looks very good on paper, but where they would want to succeed is first the next match versus Chad at the World Cup qualification. So it's their fellow African compatriots that they have to be worried about next, and we'll be looking forward to that and wish them all the best for that, as well as Papua New Guinea, who have it against Fiji.
Coach Savoy will be a happy man after this wonderful performance in the both the games for his team. I'm sure he would have find the correct combination moving forward for some important games.
And he did mention that most of the players are not with the squad. Most of them have been given permission to stay with their club teams, as the referee Akila signals for full time at the Racecourse International Stadium in Sri Lanka. Three goals in the first half and two in the second for the Central African Republic. Well, easy as 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5 as well. Papua New Guinea not lucky with any of their chances. They were really out-muscled and the plan really worked against them, except for maybe the first 10 minutes where they did have a fair bit of chances. But unfortunately for them, it ends here. Central African Republic 5, Papua New Guinea 5. Beg your pardon, that was Central African Republic 4 and Papua New Guinea 0.
What a day it has been for Central African Republic as they win this particular game comprehensively, as they did the first game. So two landslide victories for Central African Republic in FIFA Series 2024 Sri Lankan edition. Winning the first game by 6-0 and the second game comprehensively 4-0. Pretty dominating performance by the forwards of Central African Republic.
There's your hat-trick getter, Christian Theodore. Wonderful match by him. First one was a goal that was guided through. Second one was a cheeky flick. And the third one was a good left-footed strike as well. And there you have it, the player of the match. Godam Thierry.
Wonderful day for Godam Thierry there, scoring a hat-trick. This is a full-time score, as you see on the screen. Central African Republic 4 and Papua New Guinea. And we go downstairs for interview.
It was a tough game today. What are your thoughts about today's game?
Yes, obviously, tough game. I mean, coming up against, you know, a good opposition like Central Africa, it's tough. But, you know, fair to the boys, especially in the second half, trying to stick in. Obviously, we didn't want to concede in the second half, but it was tough under the conditions and we just had to push through.
Yeah, thank you very much, and hope you enjoy the rest of your stay in Sri Lanka. Thank you.
Thank you. Warren, tough outing today with the heat and also against the play and all. What are your thoughts about today's match?
It's what we expected it to be. We know they're a high-quality opposition. They got players playing all over Europe, professional players, and again, it's for our boys, it's a huge challenge. We expected it to be tough today, and I thought on the whole we handled it quite well. But for us, fitness showed in many aspects of our game, and that the key for us is to improve in our fitness and our national domestic competition by playing more games, because we were out of season coming into this tournament. So I thought overall we've done fantastically well against Sri Lanka, and we've done at times against a high quality opposition today, we've done really well.
Thank you, Warren, and I hope you enjoy your stay today. Thank you.
Have the highlights of the match between Papua New Guinea and Central African Republic. That was the first goal for Central African Republic. followed up with some valiant attempt and close chances for Central African Republic. Ghislaine creating chances one after the other. That was the second goal for Central African Republic. There was another chance. And the third goal there for Central African Republic. Chances created one after the other. One more finish cleanly there by Godami Thierry, the hat-trick player for Central African Republic. Even second half chances with ample opportunities for Central African Republic, creating chances one after the other. Bit of a decent job there done by Ronald Morrison.
And there's another goal.
That was the fourth goal for Central African Republic, finishing with a goal tally of 4-0.
Really worked against them, except for maybe the first 10 minutes where they did have a fair bit of chances.
Putting the wits again each.
And there we have it. Central African Republic easily seeing out their campaign with 6 goals in the first game against Bhutan, comfortably done, as well as today 4-0. And we'll be heading to the presenter down with us.
What a spectacular play today. Dashing the grounds and creating an environment where the atmosphere was almost red. Thank you, Central African Republic and Papua New Guinea, for this immaculate performance today. And before congratulating the winning team, I would like to thank both the teams, as this will be their last match on Sri Lanka in this international friendlies. And talking about the match today, congratulating the team, winning the match by 4-0. And this is the second great win for African Republic today and the last day, as the team has managed to score without giving any chance. What an immaculate defense at the same time. So the goals was scored by Christian Theodore, one goal, and from Donim Terry, 3 goals. So congratulating the players and also the two coaches. And also been talking about the Papua New Guinea. This has been their second match after competing with Sri Lanka on Friday and drawing it to 0-0. And today they have performed a little bit, but I think according to rankings and both the team's performances, this has been a really spectacular, breathtaking ground movement today. So looking forward to the next match between Sri Lanka and Bhutan at 8:45 p.m. We'll get back to you with a new round of atmospheric pressure, and also would love to join our next live at 85. Thank you so much.